Good evening. The Prime Minister and Premier have been on the fire ground in the Bega Valley, praising crews and the community. Three homes were lost and thousands of hectares of land destroyed in the first taste of what's ahead this bushfire season.
Prime Minister.
In the fire zone, months before anyone would have expected.
At the worst of times, we see the best of the Australian character.
Thanks so much.
The Prime Minister thanks firefighters from across the state after they all but defeated the first monster inferno of the season.
We're just at the beginning of October and already we have a serious fire here.
In its path, small communities south of Bermagui, the blaze tearing through 15 kilometres of bush in just a few hours.
The fire season is absolutely here and we need to take this seriously.
Three homes confirmed lost around Cuddagi Lake and Barriga Bay, but many more saved by our heroes in yellow.
Then it'll come down.
With the help of fireys, Tammy and Graham Millington stayed behind to defend their bush paradise until the flames came too close for comfort, the pair taking shelter on the beach overnight.
Graham was trying to put it out with my straw broom, that burnt, and I couldn't find my car keys, so I ran. There was no point in staying here, not with the fires going the way they were, and it was just like that.
This morning, pure relief, their property was largely untouched.
Feel lucky?
Lucky, blessed.
We're happy with the outcome. It could have been worse.
Just down the road, another near miss at this historic community centre. You can see just how close the flames came to engulfing the iconic Murrah Hall. It took dozens of firefighters to save this 120-year-old jewel in the Sapphire Coast's crown.
They basically encircled it and saved the hall.
Hundreds of crews worked through the night to hose down homes and gain the upper hand with help from a cool change. In the daylight, reinforcements were brought in from above, while on the ground, a reminder of the lingering dangers, this driver ending up in Bega Hospital after his ute was hit by falling branches.
One gust of wind from fire-attracted trees and they become deadly, so please take care.
The memories of the deadly Black Summer fires still haunt the south coast.
This must be an incredibly traumatic experience. We can smell, we can see the impact that these fires are having.
Locals and residents warned to be ready for what could be round two.
If you are on holidays on the New South Wales south coast or you're heading to the beach for the second week of the New South Wales school holidays, it's extremely important that you understand where evacuation centres are and that you listen to official broadcasts.
In Bermagui, Eliza Edwards, Nine News.
And let's go to Eliza in Bermagui tonight. Eliza, changing conditions are making it difficult for firefighters there this evening.
They are, Pete. On one hand, the heavy rain that's falling tonight will help crews contain the fire that's still burning, but slippery, boggy conditions will also make it hard for them to access isolated areas. The community here is very much on edge after this early scare in the bushfire season, but they have reason to feel relief tonight as this blaze is downgraded to advice level. Pete?
OK, Eliza, we'll leave you in Bermagui and go to Hayley Francis at RFS headquarters in Sydney. Hayley, how many fires are burning across the state tonight?
Pete, there are close to 60 fires burning right now. Of those, around 25 are yet to be contained by firefighters who are working tirelessly to keep these blazes away from homes. More than 800 personnel from both the Rural Fire Service and Fire Rescue are engaged in this fight, including those in this operation centre behind me. They are carefully monitoring each of these blazes as well as weather conditions to ensure the best chance of getting that upper hand. Pete?
Hayley, thank you.